Hi, my name is Zubin and welcome to HR Speak. Today we have with us Mr. Imdad Ali. He is the Chief HRM of Tata Steel Kalinganagar. So let us welcome Imdad to our show. Imdad, welcome.
Thank you. My pleasure.
It's really good to have you in our show because there are a lot of things we believe that we can learn from you. But first, I would like to start off with a very simple question, which is, we want to know more about you, both professionally and personally.
Okay. So I'll start with personally first, and then come to professionally. So I'm basically born and brought up in Jamshedpur. And after my MBA HR in from XISS Ranchi, I started my career in Tata Steel through campus interview. And I've worked in Tata Steel since 1986 June, when I was appointed as a trainee HR, management trainee HR. Of course, I have worked, to tell you about my family. My parents were also, both of them were born and brought up in Jamshedpur. My father was in government service, but most of the time he was in Jamshedpur. So we preferred to carry on in Jamshedpur even after he retired from service. My wife is from Bokaro. Again, the roots are in Bengal. My roots are also in Bengal, but we have never stayed in Bengal. Mm-hmm. I have a son and a daughter. My son has just started working. He also has done his MBA HR and has joined as a management trainee last year in Tata Steel at Jamshedpur. And my daughter just completed graduation from Mount Carmel, Bangalore. My wife is a teacher and she's at Jamshedpur. I'm in Kalinganagar for almost a little less than 2 years.
Okay. All right. So really good to know a little bit about you. Let me get back a few years earlier, you know, when you started your career. So how do you see the difference from when you started and it's been many years and now? Has the workplace changed? Do you see any change in the behavior of the employees over generations?
Yeah, I have actually seen 3 decades of HR and IR. I have worked in different, though it's the same company, but I've actually worked in various businesses, various units and various locations of the company. So I've actually seen the changing way of dealing with IR or ER, so to say. And of course, one striking feature has been we see less of people now. When we started our career about 30 years ago, there were a lot of people in the organization. So for example, in Tata Steel at that point of time, we had 70,000 plus, and Tata Steel was not even a 3 million ton company. Today, Tata Steel is 13 million ton company, and we have half that number and across all locations. So it has made a huge impact. That means the technology. All the older plants have been replaced with newer technology, newer plants. So that's why we see fewer people in different areas, different, including offices. We see very few, absolutely few people in the offices, because most of the things have been automated. And in this era of digitalization, a lot of work has actually gone into digitalization and IT enablement. So that's a change. As far as ER is concerned, I would say people are more aware of their rights, and not that they don't want to, show teamwork. They continue to do so, but they would not like to be taken for a ride by, I would say, the union leaders. So while they have every right to accept the leadership of people, they also take quick decisions to even change the leadership, and that I have seen in quite a few units of Tata Steel. So people are more aware, I would say, and they can't be taken for a ride. They can't be taken for granted.
Okay.
So that's a big change which has happened over the years. Earlier people never used to open up, but these days they will just not hesitate to open up.
And so also over the years, have you also developed a specific aspect of HR which you think is very close to your heart?
See, in my experience, I would say for my initial 14 or 15 years, it was primarily a personnel and IR focus. That means plant HR.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas that is how the HRM division was structured in Tata Steel. From 2001 onwards, I moved from the core IR to core HR function, which was more to do with the executives.
Mm-hmm.
And I continued to be in the HR function for about 12 years. And then in 2013, when the HR and IR functions again were actually clubbed and merged into one HRM function, everybody started doing both HR and IR.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, people, I have seen a trend, especially the recent batches, they would not probably want to start with IR. They would want to be within the comforts of the HR domain, so to say,
mm-hmm.
be happy doing recruitment, talent management, some bit of compensation and campus recruitment. But the core HR is actually in the plant.
Mm-hmm.
So now I get to do both HR and IR, and not only me, each and every one of us, we have in Tata Steel, we do both HR and IR. So that's a big change which has happened in the last, five years.
And how do you think this is going to change over the next, say, 5 or 10 years?
See, this structuring of HRM is actually going to help the youngsters, the professionals. So not that they are going to spend too long in a particular area. We have a system of rotation. So one can easily, if somebody is placed in the plant or the collieries or mines, they actually go through the grind of hands-on experience of dealing with people. That's very important in the initial phase of anybody's career. So if somebody misses out on this aspect of HR, IR experience, then in the long run, it becomes difficult for those people to get back from the so-called HR role to the plant IR role. They are not able to cope up with the demands of IR.
Mm-hmm. So like you said, the trend today with the younger HR folks is to be in a comfort zone
initially. Yes.
How would you motivate the youngsters to take up roles where, you know, they have to move out of the comfort zone as say an HR head? How would you play that role? How would you do that?
For example, I'll tell you, I'm in Kalinganagar, so I have around 22 people in my team. Most of them are in the plant, but some of them are not in the plant. They're doing talent management, recruitment job, some bit of compensation, MIS jobs. But I always, even though they are not earmarked to do plant HR job, I always try to involve them in plant HR job, which is basically dealing with IR.
Mm-hmm.
So otherwise, I find that people will actually feel scared to get into the plant later.
Yeah, yeah.
If they don't have a taste of dealing with plant HR or IR, then it actually becomes difficult later in. So one has to do the domestic inquiry, for example.
Mm-hmm.
So I have seen quite a few people who have actually been in the HR domain, but they hesitate when it comes to actually dealing with an act of indiscipline on the part of employees. Then he's not able to even conduct an inquiry, which is, not correct. So one should get that exposure of managing discipline, enforcing discipline, managing ER, be with the people, meet people, and get to know the pulse of the people. It's what HR all about, IR.
So in your experience of dealing with people, and I'm primarily focusing on IR right now.
Yes.
What has been the most challenging situation that you've ever faced?
I would say when I was in the initially, when I was in the, and that time I was much younger, initially when the cement plant was being established at Jamshedpur, Tata Steel was diversifying for the first time into cement operations, or rather cement business. So that's how this plant was established at Jamshedpur. It was actually a split located plant. The clinkerization unit was, at that point of time, it was Madhya Pradesh, now it's Chhattisgarh, in a place called Sonadi, which is about 100 kilometers from Raipur. So we had the limestone mines and the clinkerization unit there, and the grinding and the packing unit at Jamshedpur. So the clinker used to get transported from Madhya Pradesh to Jamshedpur, and the slag from the Tata Steel plant, which is a byproduct in the steel operations, the slag, and then it was mixed and it was in the cement. So this plant which has come up at Jamshedpur, which is just behind Tata Motors plant, Jojobera, there was a lot of agitation by the local people after the land was acquired by Tata Steel to set up this plant. So dealing with this external forces, sometimes they have political affiliations also. At that point of time, a particular party was coming up. They were becoming stronger and stronger. So dealing with these people was a big problem. At on certain days, it used to be a huge problem because they would suddenly announce a gate blockade. Mm-hmm. And then some of us in the plant, both HR, administration, plant people, project people, we used to decide to stay back in the plant and along with the help of security and the local administration deal with the situation. Mm-hmm. So we have seen, so this was I would say initial challenges that I faced at cement plant, and I continued to be there. The plant was established, it was commissioned, and then it was running fine, and then the management decided to come out of cement business. So that cement experience was a solid experience, I would say, IR point of view. And the next most important, then of course I was in Jamadova, but that was mainly HR. Kalinganagar is a big challenge. It's a huge steel plant complex. Today it's 3 million ton. First phase operations have started about 2.5 years ago. The second phase has just started, and it'll in again less than 3 years time it will become a 8 million ton company. Jamshedpur is 10 million and this is going to become 8 million. Of course, in due course there are plans for a next phase, subsequent phase, which will take it to 16 million. Mm-hmm. So Kalinganagar being in Orissa, of course we are getting a lot of support from the government, but then there are a lot of issues around the external environment, of managing the external environment, managing the contractor workers. There are different forces who are there. So it's a big challenge, I would say, and it's independent. Mm-hmm. Jamshedpur is a 100-year-old story. So people know Tata Steel. It's right in the heart of the city. People are well-wishers of the company. And I mean, there are issues. But then, since this is new, this is just 2.5 years old, the challenges of dealing with ER, IR and external environment is a little more compared to probably what I had to experience in my earlier role in Jamshedpur.
Okay. So, coming to the final section of our discussion, would you like to give a couple of suggestions to our audience who would primarily be from the HR background, some suggestions where you think they, which would help them develop, improve in their work, in their career?
I would suggest that any fresh MBA, right out of any B school, when he or she decides to join a manufacturing setup, then that person should preferably work in the plant HR role, which is IR. And so that connect with the people has to be built. That's very important. You must experience how it feels like meeting people, reaching out to people, and building up that connect with people. So, and then it, you get that confidence of managing ER and IR. Whenever there's a crisis, you will not shy away from taking that responsibility of dealing with this situation. Many people are actually scared to probably face an unruly mob. But if early, if somebody gets this exposure early in his career, then it becomes very easy. I was fortunate that way. My first posting was not in the steel plant, but in the unit which is about 14 kilometers on the western part of the city, which is known as TGS, which is Tata Growth Shop, and it manufactures steel plant equipment. So it's basically an engineering workshop. That point of time, there were about 2000 employees, and there was a lot of IR crisis at that point of time. And I was absolutely new. Of course, I didn't really contribute anything, but it was a great learning experience for me. Mm-hmm. So my seniors, I could see from very close quarters how they were able to deal with crisis IR situations. So that was a real good opportunity for me to get that type of exposure and learn the ropes.
All right, Imdad, thank you so much for sharing your experiences and also giving us a few suggestions. It was great having you in our show. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
So we were listening to Mr. Imdad Ali. I hope we've learned a lot from him, If you have enjoyed listening to him, learnt a lot from him, please like the video, share it with your friends, your colleagues, your peers. And until the next time, goodbye.